This is the video lecture on the accounting equation and basic financial statements. First of all, we're going to talk a little bit about the accounting equation. And the accounting equation is very important as a background assumption that we utilize in accounting. And this first version that we're going to look at is the most basic format of the accounting equation. And as you can see, the accounting equation would be the assets equal liabilities plus equity. So in order to understand that equation, we need to understand the meaning of each item in the equation, so that way we can understand the relationship between these items. So the first item would be assets. And assets are something that we work with a lot in accounting. Basically, assets are resources that the company owns. So these are the things that are very positive. These are things that we want to own in the business and utilize in the business. And there are going to be many different examples of assets. But initially, if you look at the few that we have listed here, cash, buildings, equipment, and land, you know, all four of these are assets. These are things that many businesses own. They are things that are used to run the business, and they have an overall positive effect on the business, which is a very good thing. Then we have a category of liabilities. Now, liabilities are almost like the opposite of assets. Liabilities are actually negative. So liabilities represent debts or things that we are responsible for. So these have a very negative effect on the business. And there are going to be many different liabilities, but perhaps the most popular and the most often used by most companies would be the accounts payable or wages payable, for example. But like I said, moving forward, we'll have many different liabilities that we will talk about eventually, but they all have a negative effect. And really the key ingredient is that every liability will ultimately require some type of a sacrifice. In other words, in the future, we're going to have to either pay money or provide some type of a service or provide some type of a product in order to settle that debt, to settle that liability. And then we have the third component, which is equity. And equity represents the owner's claim on assets. And it's also further divided into four basic components. So if we wanted to look at equity in a little bit more detail, we would actually want to look at the four separate components that make up equity. Now the first component is called capital. Capital is the owner's equity. Everything that the owner has contributed to the business is going to be reflected in the capital. So overall, this has a very positive effect on the company. So every time the owner invests anything, it is going to be included in that capital. But then we have something called the withdrawals. And this is the situation when an owner removes items from the business. So perhaps they might remove cash from the business, or they might remove assets from the business. Anything that goes from being a business asset to personal is considered to be a withdrawal. And so that's going to have a negative effect on the business. And then the third component is called revenue. Now we've talked a little bit about revenue before in an earlier video. Remember we said that some businesses provide a service, some sell a product, but they all do something in order to make money. And that money is called the revenue. And the revenue that comes in, that is an inflow. That's money coming into the business and having a very positive effect on the business. And then the fourth component of equity are the expenses. The expenses are an outflow, and they have a negative effect. So every time we have to pay the utilities, or salaries, any of those expenses that we pay, they all are recorded as an expense, and they do have that negative effect. So those are the four individual components that make up the larger component of equity. So now that you know those four components, we now see a different version of the accounting equation. You see the original version included here, the assets equal liabilities plus equity, but then you see the slightly expanded form where you see equity broken out into the four separate components: positive capital, negative withdrawals, positive revenue, and negative expense. That's the effect that each one of these components has on equity. But the idea is that if we counted up all the assets that the business owns, it should be equal to all the debts and all the equity netted together. That's the basic relationship that we always expect to see between these different components. So once we have seen the accounting equation, that opens up the question, how is the accounting equation actually used? Well, the rule about the accounting equation is that it must always be in balance. Or in other words, like I said, every single asset that we have totaled together must be equal to all the liabilities and the equity totaled together. If that relationship isn't in balance, then that is a real red flag that something is wrong with the accounting. So in many ways, the accounting equation is almost like a system of checks and balances so that we can always be sure that everything has been recorded properly. And if everything is accurate, then that accounting equation will be in balance. Now, the next thing we want to talk about in this lecture are the financial statements. Now, the financial statements are the ultimate goal of the accounting process. You'll recall that in an earlier video, when we talked about accounting, I said that accounting is not just recording the information, it's also communicating the information. So after the recording part of it has been complete, then the information is published and communicated to the people. And the way we accomplish that is by using the financial statements. And there are four main financial statements that we can use. So here's a list of our four main financial statements. We're going to talk about each one of these in detail. And eventually we'll have practice at preparing all these statements. So first of all, we have the income statement, statement of owner's equity, balance sheet, and statement of cash flows. So the first statement is the income statement. This is the statement that shows all the revenues and all the expenses. Or in other words, all the money that we are making and all the money that we're having to spend by paying out these various expenses. It also communicates whether or not the company has actually made money or lost money. So that's very important. And notice this. It's not just whether or not we made or lost money, but it's whether or not we made or lost money in the current period. And remember, we talked earlier about time periods. So I could actually prepare an income statement for the entire year, for one particular month, for one particular quarter. I could prepare a different income statement for every time period and show whether or not we made or lost money. Now, ultimately, a good way to help you remember what has to be on the income statement is actually an equation. It's a profit equation, and if you know this equation, then it will be very, very easy to remember all the things that should appear on the income statement. And it's a very simple equation. Revenue minus expense equals, and then you'll either have a positive answer, which would be a net income, or a negative answer, which means you've had a net loss. So it's really that simple. Revenue minus expense. If it's a positive answer, you made money. Negative answer, you lost money. Now, this is a good time to mention this. You'll notice that I've put net loss in parentheses. Whenever we put something in parentheses in accounting, that is to designate that it is a negative. So, like I said, if I get a negative answer to that equation, that means I have sustained a loss. The second financial statement is the statement of owner's equity. This statement shows how the owner's equity has changed. And of course, many things happen. The owner might have invested in the business. The owner might have withdrawn things from the business. We may have had a net income. We may have had a net loss. So all these things have an effect on our equity. And this statement would show how that equity has changed over time. Sometimes there is no change. Sometimes the equity has actually gone down, but typically you would expect to see an increase in the equity. That's usually what you would see on most statement of owner's equity statements. Then you have a statement called the balance sheet. Now the balance sheet, this is going to show all the assets, all the liabilities, and again, the equity. It also will show the relationship that exists between all these different elements. And a good way to remember what appears on the balance sheet is to simply remember the accounting equation. Because notice how the accounting equation goes hand in hand with the balance sheet. What are the three things that it shows? The assets, the liabilities, and the equity. And it also shows what? The relationship. Well, that's also shown in that accounting equation. We know that the assets must equal the liabilities plus equity. And as long as that relationship is true, we know that everything has been recorded properly. So we expect to see that on the balance sheet. In fact, we've said before, the accounting equation always has to be in balance, and that's actually how they came up with the name balance sheet. And then the next statement is the statement of cash flows. And this statement is used to show the inflow and outflow of cash. It's very important as a business that we always take a look at how much cash we have, because we always want to make sure that we have enough cash on hand to pay any debts. So that's what the statement of cash flows is going to show us. And if we do have any potential cash problems, we'll be able to see that on the statement of cash flows. In other words, do we have more money going out than coming in? If that's the case, you know, we might be able to survive that way for a short period of time, but we're not really going to be able to survive that way very long. So this is going to give us a warning ahead of time. If we're headed in that direction, the statement of cash flows will let us know that. So that's a very important financial statement.